In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie.
Excelsis Deo.
Et in terra pax hominibus, gloria voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratias.
Yeah. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that always pondering spiritual things, we may carry out both in word and deed that which is pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to the whole Israelite community and tell them, 'Be holy, for I, the Lord, your God, am holy. You shall not bear hatred for your brother or sister in your heart. Though you may have to reprove your fellow citizen, do not incur sin because of him. Take no revenge and cherish no grudge against any of your people. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord." The Word of God.
Kind and merciful.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that you are the temple of God, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God, which you are, is holy. Let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you considers himself wise in this age, let him become a fool so as to become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the eyes of God. For it is written, God catches the wise in their own ruses. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain. So let no one boast about human beings, for everything belongs to you. Paul or Apollos or Cephas, or the world or life or death, or the present or the future, all belong to you, and you to Christ, and Christ to God. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, offer no resistance to the one who is evil. When someone strikes you on your right cheek, turn the other one as well. If anyone wants to go to law with you over your tunic, hand over your cloak as well. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go for 2 miles. Give to the one who asks of you, and do not turn your back on the one who wants to borrow. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. For he makes his sun rise on the bad and the good, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers only, what is unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning. My name is Father Christopher Brashears. I am the associate pastor up at St. Eugene's, just north of here. And it is a great joy for me to be back today to celebrate Mass here, as I spent 3 good summers here in between my studies over in Rome. So it's a nice place to come back to celebrate Mass. St. Paul today, in a letter to the Corinthians, said this line that really struck me, and it is, "For the wisdom of the world is folly with God." So I was trying to think of how to address this. How was this going to work in? How was I going to talk about the folly, the wisdom being the folly of the world, the wisdom of the world being the folly in God's eyes? How was I going to address that? And one piece of common wisdom struck me, and I could not think of anything else. Just over and over again, it kept repeating itself. So here you go. Mama always said, life is like a box of chocolates. And in there, it is a good kind of wisdom thing, but nowadays, as we've just had Valentine's Day, there is the little key code in there that tells you exactly what you're going to get, so you're not surprised by a nougat. But there's also other types of wisdom in the world today, which is not maybe perfect wisdom. Perfect meaning that it has the fullness of the use of reason. Now, God gave us this amazing gift, one of our preeminent gifts, and that is to use our reason well. But we can't do it perfectly. We lack that ability to reason to the level that God reasons. Still good, but a little flawed, and in need of correction. One such wisdom or mentality that is prevalent today is relativism. Relativism is that system that says everybody has their own truth, you live your life by your own thing, and no truth is greater than any other truth. You do you. The problem with that is that it is what's called a self-defeating system. A nice long hyphenated word for a Scrabble contest. The self-defeating system of relativism falls on the fact that it says that everybody's truth is equal, it's good enough for them, and no truth can be over one another. No truth is universal except for that one. No truth is universal except for the truth that no truth is universal. Relativism already fails in its very first step, trying to make something true for everything by saying that nothing is true for everyone. And Jesus comes to us in the gospel again with a challenge. And that's what this challenge is, to look at the wisdom of the world and to say, where is it good enough? Where does it need improvement? Jesus is talking today and brings up this very old adage, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Now, while most of us have probably heard of this, maybe don't know all of it behind it, that this is part of Hammurabi's code. And I didn't know when it was created, so I had to look that up. It was 1754 BC that Hammurabi's code was established. And I talk about it like a law, but it's not quite a law so much as it is just precepts. A law would talk about someone's rights and the defense of those rights. But instead, this is just the law of the king, what he has put forth, his precepts to be followed. Now, some other interesting ones, maybe as number 22, that when a thief is found in the act, he is put to death. Thankfully, not so strong, because when I was 7 or 8 years old, I stole a piece of gum from the store and was caught. I'm very thankful we don't follow this one anymore. Number 104, that whenever you are to exchange business, a receipt is to be given, something we still have today. Number 53, if your negligence causes the damage of another person's income, you can be sold off to pay for that debt. And then we come to 196, which is the eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Now remember, this system was in the 17th century, 18th century BC. And it may have even influenced the Jews, as it was a very prolific system. We still have some of these things in effect today. But In one case particular, it may have influenced Moses on divorce. For the Code of Hammurabi talks in 142 about how to divorce, how to set that all up. And as we know earlier in the Gospel of Matthew, we hear, in the beginning it was not so. Moses, for the hardness of your hearts, allowed for this, but this is not how God intended it. This is a corruption of God's wisdom, the truth, into something which is the wisdom of the world. And Christ comes to correct that, but also to draw us into the truth. For instance, this eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth, he goes on, he says, to correct that, he says, but when someone strikes you on your right cheek, give him the other cheek. If anyone wants to go with you to law over your tunic, hand over your cloak as well. Now, this third one is what is maybe most striking to the Jews, because this one has a much deeper significance. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go for 2 miles. Now, on the surface, it might not sound so bad. Okay, well, you just, you know, laundry list of these things. But to the Jews, this represented their great evil oppressors, the Roman Empire. It was the Romans who could do this. It's the Romans who could press anyone into service, anyone within their territories. They could just point them out and say, you, drop what you're doing and come help me. They could not press you into service for more than a mile, though. That was the law of the empire. But Jesus here is not only saying, you know what, it may be unjust what they're doing. It may be wrong what they're doing to press you into service, but continue with them for 2 miles. Go the extra mile. And to the Jews, this was a hard thing to hear. But Jesus never shied away from giving us the hard things to hear. He also goes on and talks about you shall love your neighbor. You've heard it said that you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. In the first reading today in Leviticus, we heard love your neighbor. Period. Or love your neighbor as yourself. Period. We did not hear this addition onto there and hate your enemy. This is an addition that came on later, and Jesus is correcting them. He's saying, listen, that's not what is true. You should not hate your enemy. Rather, love your enemy. Pray for those who persecute you. Because in that way, you will become children of the Heavenly Father. I often think of our relationship with God as Father and little child. I see we have some young kids in here today. And at a certain point, your moms and dads sat there and they'd sit on the edge of the couch. And you, as you were learning how to crawl, they would say, come here. Come here. Come to me. Just a little bit. Try a little bit. Come on. You can do it. And when you started to walk, the same thing. Little by little, encouraging you to move, to work up, to build up to walking on your own 2 feet. We've all gone that same path. And Jesus challenges us in the same way. Don't just be comfortable, because you need to learn how to crawl. You need to learn how to walk. Move away from these things of comfort, of just sitting in the wisdom of the world, and move. Come to a greater knowledge, a more grown-up knowledge of God. He challenges us every time. And in fact, if we do not hear a challenge in the scriptures when we come to Mass on Sunday, go home, spend a little time, and read it again. I imagine you'll find the challenge in there. Because God is always calling us to something greater. He's calling us to move to a new place, to have our own abilities, to stand on our own 2 feet and to walk. If we can't walk, how are we to follow in His way? And so today, as we prepare for the altar, come to know what the words mean, be perfect, completely made, the original roots of Latin, perfect, thoroughly done, thoroughly perfected, thoroughly made. What does that mean to be perfect, and how do we get there? Now let us bring our prayers and petitions before our loving Father.
For the Church, that we may live as God's holy people, recognizing the Spirit of God who dwells within each of us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are imprisoned, that God will touch their hearts, free them from their mistakes, and help them to embark upon a new journey in life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are experiencing conflict, that God will transform hearts that are hard and minds that are closed, so that violence may end and peace may be established. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are seeking employment, that God will guide them and open before them good opportunities to use their gifts and talents, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the fruitful work of this archdiocese and all its parishes, and for blessings on all who support the annual appeal, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of our beloved departed, especially Clarence Betson, and for all who are grieving the loss of a loved one, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silent prayer, let us now mention our own special intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Father Rick and the eighth graders who are on pilgrimage to the nation's capital, that God may ensure their safe travels and the fruitfulness of their journey, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious Father, as we come before you celebrating the life, death, and resurrection of your Son, that we may be blessed with these things that we ask for, may you shower down your grace upon us so we may continually work day by day build up your kingdom on earth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
word of labor, God's will is done. In the help we give our neighbor, God's will is done. In our world by just God caring for the hungry and despairing, in the harvest we are sharing.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer to the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Paul, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In commemoration with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my home, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Take and drink, take and drink.
takes away your sin. I am the gate that guards you night and day. You are my flock, you know the shepherd's voice. You are my own, your ransom is my blood. Stone that God has made, the chosen stone and precious in his eyes. You are God's dwelling place, on me you rest. Like living stones, a temple for God's praise. Came into the world. I am the light that darkness cannot hide. I am the morning star that never sets. Lift up your face, in you my light will shine.
Yeah.
If you didn't return your ACA pledge card today, please bring it back next weekend or drop it off by the office. Please sign up in the Mayfield foyer or online to help feed the hungry next Sunday. Confirmation will take place next week at 12:15 p.m. Mass. You can buy Girl Scout cookies in the foyer after Mass today, and also join us in the atrium after Mass to welcome our new parishioners. Now I'd like to invite up Jeff Whitmarsh for an announcement on the men's conference.
Thank you, Father. Today's second reading says that you are a temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you. Many holy men have taught me that the secret to being a temple of God lives in keeping spiritually fit, and that's what the Catholic Men's Conference is all about. Between the sacraments and many great speakers, the Men's Conference is an opportunity to get a thorough spiritual workout. I can safely say that I'm a better man today because of this conference. The conference is Saturday, April 1st at the Embassy Suites in Norman. The cost is $59 if you sign up by March 6th and $69 after. You can visit catholicmen.net for more information or get a brochure from Joe Corey at the welcome desk after Mass. So if you would like to improve in love and in your spiritual life, I encourage you to consider the Men's Conference. Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may experience the effects of the salvation which is pledged to us by these mysteries, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.